Hello friends, welcome to Pioneer of Success. Today we will be talking about citation with EndNote, editing a citation and putting abbreviated journal name in citation. So how to do that? Let us go to a Word file. Suppose I have written something and I want to put some references in many places within this text. Suppose I want to put some reference here. I have already taken one EndNote file that I have created in the last lecture, and I have named this EndNote file as YouTube video, and I want to put certain citations. Say this particular citation I want to put. So what I do, I go to insert citation and I click on insert selected citation. As I have already mentioned, if you do that, this citation will come at the bottom. Suppose another citation I want to put, say this second one. What I do, again I go to you should keep the cursor here and then go to the insert citation selected citation. See, second citation has come. Now I want to add more citations, say this one. Then what I do, I download the citation EndNote file, then double click on it. I go to here. As I have already told, sometimes journal name comes with the author. You have to segregate it. It might be the mistake from the EndNote style or from the EndNote software. Sometimes it happens, but you don't need to bother much. You just need to check whether everything is in correct position or not. If it is not, then you have to correct it, like I have corrected the journal. Then again click here, go to certain place where you want to put the reference. Say I want to put it here. Again insert selected citation. So I have put three references. So let us write it references. Now what to do? I have to do certain things. Suppose I have mistakenly added a certain citation and I want to remove it. In order to do that, in the Word document, you get an option, edit and manage citation. You just need to click on it and let us see what are the things available in this option and what we can do from this tab, that is edit and manage citations. So you can see in this particular section, you have the numbers written and that matches with the citation numbers. Say this is the first one, this is Kimling. So this paper is showing hashtag 1 means the first citation, hashtag 2 second citation. This is Singh paper, CVV Singh. So you can just correlate which citation is located at what place. Now suppose I want to remove the citation too. How to do that? Before telling that, you should see one thing. In the library, it is written YouTube video. What does it mean? I have created a library. Library means the EndNote file where I am putting all the references. You see, three references I have put. So here, this is interfaced with that EndNote file. And what is happening? Those citations are coming from this library, YouTube video. Here, I will give you one suggestion. And that is, keep all the citation in a particular library. Otherwise, what will happen, some citations will come, say, from the YouTube video library. Some other citations may come from another library you created. But later on, handling those things will be difficult. So I always tell, make a single library, put all the references there. From that library, put the references in your Word file. That means the citations you put from this library, so that you can handle it better. Now I was telling that I want to remove citation number 2. So what you need to do, go here, click on the drop down menu, and there are certain options like edit library references, find reference updates, remove citation, insert citation, update from my library. Here I want to remove it, so I just click on remove citation, and then you have to click on OK. Once you do that, that is automatically removed. And one thing, have you noticed or not, initially this citation was citation number 3, now it has become 2. So you don't need to change the numbering. If you remove a certain citation, if you insert another citation, it will automatically renumber, and this is how this is automated. and you don't need to bother about the numbering. If you do it manually, every time you add a reference, you have to change the numbers of all other references, and which is a hectic job. Now I will show you how to put abbreviated name of the journal. Suppose here the name of the journal is Journal of Physical Chemistry CB, but in an article they do not write this much big name, so there are abbreviated names. So how to find that abbreviated name? Just Google, go to Google, write CASSI code for journals. There is this website will come. Click here. Click on I accept. Just write down the name of the journal. See title or abbreviation. Now search. It is taking some time. Actually, D is not there. We search again. Yeah, you can see this is the journal we are looking for, Journal of Physical Chemistry B. If I click on that, it will show the abbreviated name. So instead of Journal of Physical Chemistry B, I need to write J dot phys dot chem dot B. So I just copy it and I go to the EndNote library file. There is one option, tools. Click on the tools. You will get open term list option, and under this you will get journal term list. Just click on there. Yeah, so this is the Journal of Physical Chemistry B. I click on edit term. So this is abbreviation one is showing, and you just paste the abbreviation. Click on OK. So this abbreviation is set. Okay, now I close it. Again, I go to the citation. I click on update citation and bibliograph. You see, this Journal of Physical Chemistry B has come. Okay, so this is how you have to put the abbreviation form from the term list, and it will automatically take the abbreviated form. So there are many other things. I'll just tell you certain more things, like you have to click on configure bibliography. It is here. Now if you click here, you'll get a layout. From the layout you can choose the font. Let us put Times New Roman. I put font size 12. See, it has become 12. Now what I want to do, again you go, you can change much more things. Suppose I want 1.5 spacing, so you just click on 1.5 lines, then OK. See, it has become 1.5 lines. So based on your requirement, you can just change it, and you can make your citation style as per the requirements of the journal. So today I stop here. I just told you a few things about EndNote. In the next classes, again, I'll come one by one. We'll discuss all the things. And at the end of all the sessions or all the lecture videos, we'll be having an online session where we'll be discussing every aspect in a brief manner. And all the videos will be comprehensive teaching module, and you can learn from there. So I stop here. And thank you very much. I request you to subscribe to our channel. Write us if you have any query, we'll be happy to address.